vintage linens. Today we're going to show you how to make a wreath out of hankies. I'm going to show you, this is one that I made for myself. It matches my kitchen. It's shades of yellow and a little bit of green. And I used some just some white hankies. This is very easy to make, and it only takes a few minutes of your time. It takes more time to iron the hankies than it does to make the wreath. Let me show you a few of the items you're going to need. You're going to start off with an embroidery hoop. I like the wooden ones, but you don't need the outside. You're only going to use the inside of the embroidery hoop. I suppose you could use the outside, but I only use the inside. These are very cheap. They're only 99 cents. If you have a coupon, you can get them for 50 cents at any hobby store. You're going to need about 18 or 20 vintage hankies. The hankies that I'm using are actually, they're newer on the end of hankies. These are what I call cutter hankies. If you took a look at this a little bit closer, you're going to see the little dots where they're supposed to cut them. They're off. These hankies are not real fine linen hankies. They're just, they're cotton. They're a heavier cotton, so they hold up better. They'll stay in place a little bit better when you're doing them. You're going to need an accent ribbon. You only need about 2 feet of that, so we're going to put that aside. You're going to need a package of clear hair ties. They're little, they're for children's hair. You can buy them in any pharmacy or a Walmart or something like that. They're just little clear rubber bands. They're very small. And you're going to need, let's see, just your scissors. And that's about it. So what I'm first going to show you how to do is you're going to clean your hankies and you're going to iron them flat. You're going to fold each hanky into four. I have three here that I'm going to show you very quickly. I pre-did all the other ones so you can see what this is like. You're going to have your iron on hot. Like I said, these are not real good fabric, so you're going to iron them flat. All right. And then what you're going to do is that you're going to fold the hankies in. You want to make sure that you're going to have on your outside, you're going to be able to see the design of whatever flower it is. If you could see, you just fold it almost into thirds, like that. What you want to do when you're choosing your hankies, try to choose hankies that are all similar sized. You don't want to do a 16-inch hanky and an 11-inch hanky. You want to make sure that when you're putting them on to the hoop, they're all similar. And for this one, I chose quite an arrangement of different colors. So I'm going to lay some of these out because when I'm putting them onto the hoop, I don't want to put two colors. See, those are two hankies that are very similar. I don't want those next to each other. Take out some of these little bands. Just put them in front of you. Put the rest aside. Now what you're going to do is you're going to take the hanky and you're going to fold it over the loop. You can do it as far in as you'd like. I like it about, you fold it down so it's about in half in the back, if you can see that. And what you're going to do is you're going to take one of these loops. Just turn it around, and that's it. So let me show you how quickly this goes. You match up another one like that. See the back? Just push it over. Like I said, try to alternate your colors. You could do all of one color scheme if you'd like. This one I thought would be nice if we did it all different kinds of bright colors. There's so many different things that you can do with vintage hankies. What I like a lot about this craft is that you're not ruining your hanky. If you decide you don't like it, or if the hankies get dirty hanging on your door, or, the wreath that I made, the yellow one that I showed you, is going to be hanging in my kitchen. So it's not like it's going to be exposed to the elements, but you know, things can get dirty in your kitchen. It's not hanging near a stove or anything, so it shouldn't get too bad. I think that wreath used, it's supposed to use 15 to 18. I think that one used 19. I like to push them together a little bit. I just liked how it looked better. See how simple this is? Like I said, use newer hankies. These are all hankies. If you go on, you wanted to buy hankies, and I know that years ago when I started buying hankies on my own, you know, even 10 years ago, you could go on to eBay and you would see them, you know, hankies that you could buy in China, from China. And they look very beautiful, and they are. Hankies like that would be perfect for a craft like this because the fabric is very heavy, and so it would lend itself to holding up really well. But they're just, as I call them, cutter hankies. They're not individually made. If you buy vintage hankies, you're going to see hankies that have been hand-rolled and hand-embroidered. Some of the early ones are from, you know, Portugal and the Philippines. They have hankies from England and Spain. They've all been hand-done. I think this is going to be very pretty because there's a lot of color in it. It would go absolutely anywhere. I think I'm going to use Alright. I think one more is all we need. I did an extra one because I wasn't sure. The last one I did needed a little bit extra. Alright, I'm going to turn it around. You can see. Look how nice that's turned out already. Now, what I like to do is just pick an accent ribbon. I cut about 3 feet. Just cut the piece off. If it's too long, you really don't have to worry about it. You're going to decide where you want your bow to be, where you think you're going to hang the hanky. I think I like that one up the top. I like to have the bow a little bit offset, so that's where you're going to start to spin. And you're just going to go in between each of the hankies. Just hold it with your hand when you start. You can let go in a minute. That just holds this a little bit further on. Let me turn it off. There we go. Let This is a little bit short, so I'm just going to tie that like that. Cut myself another piece of ribbon. Just make yourself a basic bow. You can do something, I mean, if you're into making fancy bows, that is always an option. All right. Pull it down a little bit. All right. Take a look at how nice that came out. So that will look pretty on your door, your back door in the spring, summer. You can choose hankies of your liking. You can choose all of one color. I have another one set here that I'm going to do in blues. And with embroidery on. You can pick embroidery if you'd like to do it that way. But I just love the way that that looks. I just think that that is a very simple craft. Anyone can do that. And it enables you to be able to display some of your pretty hankies too. So thank you so much for watching this episode of Hanky Panky. If there's something special you'd like to see, or if you're interested in anything involving hankies, just leave it in the comments below and I'll get back with you. You can also visit my page on Facebook. It's Hanky Panky Vintage Linens. You'll see hankies that I post for sale. You might even see this wreath. We'll see. Depending on where I decide if I'm going to hang this one or not. But thank you so much for watching, and it's been a pleasure to show you how to make this. And you have a blessed day. Thank you for joining us today at Hanky Panky Vintage Linen. If you have any questions about what we've talked about today, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comments below. If you've seen any hankies or linens that you like in today's video, they may still be available. Please visit my eBay store. A link to that and my contact information is in the video description.